Good morning, good morning, good morning. Great to be alive, great to be with you another morning. Trust that as we share from the Word of God today, that the Word of God will bless your hearts and it will prepare you for this brand new day in which the Lord hath made. And as you go there, you will go in the might of the Lord and you will encourage others to trust Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, because pretty soon now we are going to be with Him. Austin Miles wrote the song entitled, If Jesus Goes With Me. Here's what he said. It may be in the valley where countless dangers hide. It may be in the sunshine that I in peace abide. But this one thing I know, if it be dark or fair, if Jesus goes with me, I'll go anywhere. If Jesus goes with me, I'll go anywhere. 'Tis heaven to me. Wherever I be, if He is there, I count it a privilege here, His cross to bear. If Jesus goes with me, I'll go anywhere. It is indeed a privilege, a joy, and a great delight to be able to share with you in the mornings and these devotions. I trust that by sharing with you, that your hearts have been encouraged, and that you have learned a little more from the Word of God, and especially as it comes to our gifts, that you are using your gifts for His honor and for His glory. We're looking at the gifted men, Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11. We looked at the apostle. We looked at the prophet. We looked at the evangelist. And now we're going to look at the pastor teacher. The pastor teacher. The word pastor translates poimen. This name or title carries the meaning of shepherd. It emphasizes the care, protection, and leadership of the man of God for the flock. The teacher, this has to do with the primary function of the pastor. Teaching can be identified as a ministry on its own. For in 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and verse 28, and God had set some in the church, first apostles, secondary prophets, he said, thirdly, teachers. This has to do with the primary function of the pastor. Yes. I find the best way to explain the pastor is to consider him as the pastor teacher. Why? Teaching is one of the functions of the pastor, one of the main functions of the pastor, the man of God. In Paul's letter to Timothy, his first letter, chapter 5 and verse 17, he said, let the elders that rule well be counted worthy of double honor, especially they who labor in the word and doctrine. Here the function of teaching is attached to that of shepherding. There is a question that should be asked for clarity, and that is, how is the pastor teacher related to the bishop and elder? The terms are different ways of identifying the same people. The word pastor carries the basic meaning of shepherd. The word bishop carries the meaning of overseer. The word elder, and the basic meaning of that could mean an older person. It is referred to in Scripture as the pastor also. As I study the Scripture, I believe it is correct to say all three terms refer to the same office. All three refer to the same office. You see, in the qualification of the bishop or the pastor that is found in 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 7, the scripture says, moreover, he must have a good report of them that are without, lest he fall into the snare of the devil. If you read from verse 1, it says, this is a true saying, if a man desired the office of a bishop, he desired a good work. The bishop must be blameless, the husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, good behavior, given to hospitality, apt to teach, not given to much wine, no striker, not greedy or filthy lucre, but patient, not a brawler, not covetous, one that ruleth well his own house, having his children in subjection with all gravity. For if a man know not how to rule his own house, how shall he take care of the house of God? Not a novice, lest being lifted up with pride he fall into condemnation of the devil. Moreover, he must have a good report of them which are without, lest he fall into the snare of the devil. And the qualification of the elder that is found in Titus now, chapter 1, verse 5 to verse 7. Notice what the scripture says. Titus, chapter 1, verse 5 to verse 7. He says, "For this cause left I thee in Crete, that thou shouldest set in order the things that are wanting, and ordain elders," watch this carefully, "in every city as I have appointed thee. If any man be blameless, the husband of one wife, having faithful children, not accused of riot nor unruly, for a bishop," all of a sudden he changed the word from elder and he used the word bishop. He says, "For a bishop must be blameless as the steward of God, not self-willed, not soon angry, not given to wine, no striker, not greedy or filthy lucre, but a lover of hospitality, a lover of good men, sober, just, holy, temperate, holding fast the faithful word as he had been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine both to exhort and to convince the gainsayers." In the qualification of the elder, in Titus 1, 5 to 7, these are used to refer to the same man. The same that we find in 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 to verse number 7. In the Peter passage, all three terms are brought together. In Peter's passage, in 1 Peter chapter 5, and verse number 1, and verse number 2, just to share a little bit of this with you this morning. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse number 1, and verse number 2. Here Peter puts it. "The elder which are among you I exhort, who am also an elder, and a witness of the suffering of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed, feed the flock of God which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not of filthy lucre, but of a ready mind, neither as being lord over God's heritage, but being an example to the flock. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, ye shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away." Now, as we come to this, we can go to the book of Acts in chapter 20. And the time is out on us this morning. And next morning, we will pick up and share from there. But let me just close by reading for you Acts chapter 20, verse 17 and verse number 28. Chapter 20, verse 17. He says, "And from Miletus he sent to Ephesus, and he called for the elders of the church." Now look at verse 28. He said, "Take heed therefore unto yourselves and to all the flock over which the Holy Ghost had made you overseer, to feed the church of God, which he had purchased with his own blood." As we look at it, elder emphasizes who the man is, and bishop speaks of what he does. Father, we are so thankful. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you that we can look in your word, learn, and understand. And we pray that you'll help us, dear Lord, to apply, for this is more important. We thank you for the pastors, whether they are called pastor, elder, bishop, presbyter. God, we just want to thank you for each and every one, and we pray you would use them mightily, and that the people that they pastor, dear God, would show their respect to these gifted men that you have given to the church as a gift. Thank you for them. Bless them, guide them, and protect them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. Time is out this morning. We love you. Do have a great day.